Yeah.
Oh, we're not looking.
Oh, she knows less than you guys.
I watched. Oh, is it on already?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Peace and love, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, and hello and welcome to another episode of Buckle Up. And man, oh man, this incredible person next to me, we met last year. And again, you know, it's the same thing with many artists. The evolution of an artist, when you see them, you know, do and grind and work and release, that's amazing. But also when you get to know them and realize they are incredible people before being artists, this is the type of person Michele is. So ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Michele. What's
Thank
up?
You. Hi.
How are you? Salam alaikum. Peace and love.
Good. I'm going to go hide under a rock after this.
Nah. Fam, you're incredible. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you.
Are you ready to buckle up?
I am. I'm excited.
She knew the lesson. She's like, we're not going to buckle up until you tell me, which is good. So let's buckle up, ladies and gentlemen. Okay. Streets of Dubai. Okay, Michele, we're gonna try to get deep with this interview. Yeah, we want to get to know you, so feel free to say and you know whatever you want.
Okay.
Last year, D3 Unplugged. This is where we all knew about you. Mm-hmm. When I say we, like you know, the music scene somehow. Harmony and D3 had this D3 Unplugged, and you were chosen to perform. Before we talk about that, I want to know. Before that, mm-hmm. How did you start getting into music? What was the story before D3 Unplugged? I'm not sure. I went to your Instagram and I saw that the first picture was D3.
Yeah, I remember everything.
Okay, cool. So tell us about like before. I'm kind of intrigued.
Yeah, of course. Mm. Okay, so basically, when I started, I was literally like, I think 3 years old when I started singing.
And, 3 years old.
Yeah.
Wow.
I've always wanted to be a singer.
Okay.
I used to like ask my parents. I used to go and do, you know, crazy. Okay, I'm losing my words, by the way. This is what happens when I'm nervous. I'm a bit nervous talking.
Why are you nervous?
I don't know, because there's so many cameras.
Oh, forget the cameras.
I don't know where to look.
There's this one. Forget that one.
All right, okay.
You know, it's all good. Be you, fam.
Okay. Mm. Yeah, I'll try.
Yeah.
So basically I used to always want to be a singer, singing since I was three. I was going to vocal classes. I had a tenor at some point for a teacher, for a vocal coach.
Was that always in the UAE or?
No, in Lebanon. So yeah, I was born and raised in Lebanon till I was 21, I think. I left for a year to the UK. And up until that time, I used to always sing, but always sing, you know, under the shower. That was my stage.
Yeah.
I was always too shy. I think class, everybody knows this. I was always too shy to, like, stage fright was crazy. I literally could not get on in front of anyone and sing. My friends had to beg me to sing if they ever wanted to.
Shout out to your friends.
Yeah, they're amazing. And so when I came to the UAE, I was like, I had a job that was not the job I have now, and it was a job that was very intense.
Okay.
Because I was working at Nestle in the chocolate factory.
Oh.
Which was, in the beginning, I was like, yes, please, because it's chocolate. It was the Kit Kat factory.
Oh, so
I was,
wow.
Like 10 Kit Kats every day I used to eat.
Easy.
Yeah. I'm not supposed to say that because I don't think I was allowed to eat 10 chocolates every day.
Too late.
Anyway,
now.
They won't know. Yeah.
Yeah.
And. And I was very miserable at some point because I was in the factory. It was very, you know, physically intense. That I used to go home and be very depressed and be like, I need to do something with my life. I got ready to start my own startup in food. And then I'm like,
wow.
Yeah. It's a complete shift that happened between when I left Nestle to the job I am at now.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And so I have a friend, my best friend here, shout out to him, Wael. He's amazing. He's
shout
been supporting
out,
me all this time. And he is the one who kind of introduced me to music here, told me there's open mics. I'll introduce you to a few people that I know that he knew that were in I think, university with him. I'm not sure which university. He's going to hate me for not knowing, but anyways.
A university.
One of those universities. And so I heard about open mics. I'm like, okay, I'm going to give it a try because I need to do something.
Mm-mm.
Khalas, I'm 24, I think, at the time I was.
And you really, at that point, you felt khalas. You really wanted.
Yeah.
One of the things I think people and myself also love about you is how you're becoming vocal about, like, okay, you know, I'm a bit shy, but I want to use music to to express myself.
Yeah.
Now, this question might really hit you hard, but I really, you know, I really want to get to know you. Close friends and family, mm-hmm. what do they think about the kind of music that you do, especially in Arabia? You're very, like, fair, unfair. You've dropped 3 songs and 1 feature so far. Correct
yes,
me if I'm
certainly.
Right. Which is amazing. The fair, unfair joint. Man, this I can't believe this is the first record.
Yeah, it's. I'm really proud of this one.
But that's your first record, fam.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
That's your first. Like, that's like. I know people are talking selfish right now, and Fire,
yeah.
Fire is my favorite, but man, I think people, you know, we forget easy. When did you drop this?
I think August.
Enjoy this for a second. Michele, come on.
Shout out to AY.
Shout out to AY. So again, close friends and family,
mm-hmm.
what do they think about the kind of music you do, especially that you're Lebanese,
yeah.
and it's very, it's, you're talking relationships, you're talking intense feelings, you know?
Mm.
How do they feel about that?
I love that you're asking this. Mm. So basically, so Fair and Fair, I have no idea what I was writing. I had no idea what I was writing. It was the very, very first song I ever wrote.
Oh, yeah.
I did not know shit about songwriting.
Okay.
So I'll tell you a funny story about this song, how I came up to creating it. So it was the first day that I got into the studio for the first time with AY, and he comes to me.
Was that after D3? Unplugged?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think it was a month after.
Okay.
That day we had said that khalas, I'm gonna come into the studio with him and do something, because somehow I was ready to do more than just covers. So yeah, which is weird, but So I go to him to the studio. We're talking so that he understands my style.
Yeah.
And he goes, okay. And I had a bunch of recordings on my phone from the previous years where I'm just, you know, just singing. Like
hummings and
everything and anything, just like no lyrics or nothing, but just melodies. And he goes, like, do you want to start a song from scratch, or do you want to start something that you have on your phone? I'm like, let's start from scratch. I just want to see how what the process
the
is
process.
Like. So he comes up with an amazing beat, amazing melody. I have it with me, and I know that I'm gonna use it with him. Like, I'm gonna make a song. But at that time, the song was very upbeat and up-tempo for my style, because
okay.
I still did that type of very chill and slow
so good
melody. Thank you. And so we make the track, and the next week I was supposed to come back to record the vocals, and he's like, okay, take it, write the song to it, and then come back. I'm like, okay. So during the weekend, I'm trying to write a song to it. I go crazy, because I'm like, I can't do this. Like, I really cannot. Like, I just had nothing. I had no lyrics. So I sit in front of the piano, and at the time I was also trying to learn how to play basic chords on the piano. And I come up with this in 5 minutes. I have the raw recording of Fair and Fair on the piano. So it was
really?
Supposed to be an acoustic one. Oh. So I go back to the studio.
You wrote it in 5 minutes? Is that what you're saying?
I wrote the melody and then I wrote the lyrics in a week, maybe.
Yo, guys, again, this is her first hit, like, song, you know? Man, how'd you come up with the name? Fair, unfair.
Ooh, very good question. I have no idea. I do things, I just don't know why I do them.
No, but it's cool, the name is cool, like, fair, unfair. And, okay, so what does the family think about that? Like, close friends and family?
Close friends are, like, they like it. No one ever commented on the lyrics themselves.
Okay.
My family. I know that they're not very happy. So
okay.
Like my parents are like I love my parents, honestly.
Bless them.
They're so open minded,
mm-hmm.
and they kind of know me as a person and how I am and how I think and how I like. They know that I'm not the conservative type, and that I'm very open, very open minded about everything.
Yeah.
So when I wrote Selfish, which is the most kind of PG-13 song. There's more PG-13 coming.
Oh, okay. You heard it here first.
Yeah. So I made them listen to it, and they're like, yeah, it's very good. So they don't comment on what I'm saying.
Okay.
Because I think that they try not to focus on the lyrics. There's one song that I did with a guy in Spain, actually, and in the lyrics, he says something that is very, very, I'm not going to say it here.
Okay.
And I made it listen to my parents, because I like to also provoke them. Yeah, nice. I don't know why I do this. Like, I love them so much, but I do that.
No, but it's cool. That kind of relationship is an open relationship.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
Exactly.
Okay.
So my dad is listening to it, and I'm just like staring at him. So what do you think? And he listens to his part, the guy's part.
Oh.
And he goes like, he removes the earphones, and he's like, is he talking about you? I'm like, no. No, dad, I don't know the guy.
Cool. Is he talking about you?
Yeah.
No, okay. That works.
There's like there's a limit to what man. I can and cannot.
Okay.
Write.
Okay. As Michele, did that ever stop you anyway from, I mean, you created three songs right now and one feature was saved. Did you ever think about that? Like the fact that your songwriting is a little bit out there for the Arab region. And for me, I really like it. And I don't like to box people in whatever it is. Just be you.
Yeah.
But again, you're in the Arab world. Does that even cross your mind? Or khalas, you just... You broke that. And
it does, for sure. When I wrote Selfish, I was like, oh shit, like, should I do this? Should I not do this? But then I'm like, you know what? No, because this is me. This is who I am. This is what I like to talk about. This is what I found that this is what I want to write about. And actually, like, funny story, when I wrote Selfish is when I realized why I want to write music to begin with. And I was talking to Shabani about it.
Shout out Shabani. We'll see you, fam.
So I was talking to her and I was like, I realized why I wrote Selfish and why I want to write this type of song is because we're in the Arab world.
Oh, nice.
And because women are not, you know, we're with society, we're not supposed to talk about these things and about, you know, having a sexuality.
So which is what music is for. Exactly. That's dope. I was going to say that. The thing is, we're still people. Regardless of Arab or not Arab, you have feelings. You have this. Exactly. This happens. Dating, boyfriend, girlfriend, spouse, wife, husband, any fee.
Exactly.
It exists. It's not like we're like, you know.
Exactly.
So I like the fact that you're addressing that. Something else I want to talk to you about, and again, allow me to break that. Anxiety and stuff like that. When it comes to, like, I personally, for example, my wife, my one and only, have that. And I've been with my wife for like 15 years or something like that. And, you know, and I understand it, but I also... It's incredible that you take music as a tool to, you know, smash that.
Yeah.
And you have to be proud of what you are and all that stuff. In what way does anxiety play a role in your kind of music? Like, if any? Like, do you address that in your music?
Not yet.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm trying to write about it because the thing with me as a person is that I'm not someone who opens up very quickly to people, except if, you know, I feel really comfortable with you, or if I, like with you, for example, I would open myself up because I know for a fact that you're not judgmental, you know, like, so you can tell by a person. If
you have a judge, come and see me, I swear to God. No, but yeah, I hear what you're saying. Yeah. I think maybe even myself, I don't realize that you only dropped three songs, fam. Three songs, one feature.
Yeah.
And in the music scene somehow right now, in the UAE at least, you're like, you know, one of the most like prolific songwriters, and even the way when you're... people talk.
No.
Yeah, I swear. I'm telling you. And I think that's a fact. Do you realize what you were able to do in the past? Like, you dropped Fair and Fair August.
Yeah.
So what I like about you is that you're consistent in terms of dropping it. You're not really going away and coming back. You know?
I did go away after Fire because I wasn't, you know, with the Lebanese revolution happening, I was like, maybe it's not the time to do that.
Yeah.
But 2020, I know that, like, I knew that because I have maybe six tracks that are ready to be released and a lot more that are being produced. And I set a goal to myself this year that I want to release at least one song a month.
Wow.
Yeah, so I'm ready to like go hard and
one song
release
a month.
Content. Mm. Yeah.
Okay.
So I am dropping my EP, which Fair and Fair and Fire are a part of. So I'm doing.
How many songs is the EP?
It's four songs in total. So two new songs are gonna come out.
Two new songs.
Yeah.
When?
I'm hoping April.
April.
March, April.
Okay.
Let's see. Before Ramadan is the goal.
Yep. Tell me about Fire.
Yeah.
I love that song.
Same.
It's my favorite.
Thank you.
It's my favorite. I mean, it's Selfish, I like it, but this one is, I'll tell you, I was listening to it on the road here, and I don't know, I'm going to just manifest something. I really imagined this song is what in one of the big series on Netflix or something like that.
I would love to.
Yeah, I mean, the whole vibe, you know? You know, there's a scene between, you know, the star and the guy and the girl, and this is it. It's perfect.
Let's do it. Yeah.
It's let's dope. Turn into Netflix, hit her up, man. I'm just saying, you know. It's so tell me about fire. You know, tell me about it, like as a song, songwriting.
Yeah, of course. So you notice, right, that I'm saying the same thing three times.
Yeah.
So that's my way of not writing a lot, because I know that I'm not good at it.
Okay.
Or like at the time I was trying to get better at it. So I just took the three parts and did it at the same time. So the way I write music is I get the melody and write to it. So again,
always melody first with you.
Exactly. Okay. So again, this one I also recorded it in 5 minutes when it comes to how I wanted it to be. So I don't like my songs to be structured. So there's no chorus in the song. There's no there is a chorus in Fair and Fair, kind of, because I think AY made me put a chorus on there. Selfish, there's no chorus either. So
yeah.
I don't like to do the structure, the normal structure in songs.
Nice.
But with Fire, what I did is, there's this website called Splice where you can get samples of melodies, right?
Yeah, this is
where I got it from.
Mm.
There's actually a lot of people who have this on their songs.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is also the con of being on Splice.
Okay.
But I was watching a Brazilian series.
You watch a Brazilian series? That's a fact you didn't know about Michele.
Well, I'm a quarter Brazilian, so I'm trying to like learn about that part of the world. So I was watching the series and I got I fell in love with Bossa Nova. So I go on Splice and I'm like Bossa Nova samples and this comes up.
Wow.
It's very like my inspiration other than Bossa Nova was also, it reminds me of Narcos a bit, you know that song?
Yeah.
And I've had that, like I've had people tell me this and I'm like, yes, you get the point, perfect. So I go there and the melody is such a sensual melody that I wanted to do something that had to do with that. So it's about meeting someone at a club, not knowing them, also again very physical side of things. And yeah, I called it Fire because of this very ending when I say Fire.
Love it.
It's like it's not intricate. I love this.
I'm telling you. So live performances with you, Michele. You have so when you performed at D3 and when you're performing across, you know, different, you know, venues over here, there is a certain. I love the way you perform live. Is that also something you had to, you know, push as well to be in front of an audience?
Oh my God.
No, because you know, I'm telling you, I take it for granted because as an MC, I grab the mic like, "What's up, everybody? How you doing?" And people tell me, "How do you do that? That's hard." Yeah. I swear to God, I thought these are real dinosaurs. Just for 1 second, we're passing by Sheikh Zayed Road. I was like, we're done. Anyway, sorry. Okay. Stage presence. Mm-hmm. How do you tackle that? Because, you know, I love it. You're very sweet, very sincere, very real. How do you tackle that?
So, I still struggle with it. I don't practice before I go on stage, which is something wrong because most of the time I don't know what to say and I get so caught up with my words and I can get very awkward and because I'm trying to come off as exactly who I am. I don't want to come off as someone else, you know, talk differently or say stuff that are different. And when I talk, usually there's a lot of sarcasm in what I say.
Yeah.
And most people don't understand it. So it comes off as, I agree.
Just be you, you know
what
I mean?
Yeah. I agree.
I mean, look, from the three or four times I saw you perform, you were really yourself. And I just think people take it for granted. Generally, I'm talking about stepping on stage is something really not easy.
It is. It's not like easy at all.
You don't know who's watching, you don't know who's what, you don't know what's going to say. You know.
I'm so much better now. Like I used to, the very, very first time not the very first time in the UAE, but I think the very first time when I was young, I remember I think my first performance was at a ballet recital.
What?
So I used to do ballet for 2 years. Let's not even go
get
there.
Back
I don't
to
even
that.
Remember. I did not like it at all.
Okay.
So
ballet. Wow.
Yeah, I did 1 year with my older sister, 1 year with my younger sister, and
bless.
The second year, they knew that I sang. So this woman, the teacher, came to me and she's like, "I want you to sing." I'm like, "Sure." So we go to rehearsals the day before. I don't know when exactly. That was like a long time ago. And she's like, It was a French song that's very upbeat, you know, trying to get everybody to clap in the audience. And she's like, okay, so sing the song and walk around on stage, left, right, left, right. I'm like, yeah, yeah, I can do it. So there was no one, obviously. So okay. I was just, you know, running yeah. around the stage singing. And then the next day or whenever the performance was, I have a video of it. I'm literally frozen singing. I was shaking. My eyes only were moving. I was wow. so scared. And this was me the first time I performed, I think, here in the UAE. At Go Play the World. Again, shout out to Abo.
Shout out Amazing. To Abo. Like, we miss you, man.
Yeah. Honestly. This is where I started, and with time, I got
You remember that night, the Go Play the World?
Yeah, I do. It was backing tracks, and I used to always stop myself from performing because I'm like, oh, I can't play an instrument, I can't perform. And I think it was an excuse, in a way, for me not to sing at all because I was, you know, shy and I had stage fright. And then I was like, you know what, fuck it. I need to do this.
Yeah.
I'm a grown-ass woman. I need to do something about music. About
and you love
voice.
It, no?
And I love it.
Yeah, you.
I it's my passion.
Why do you like music? What made you fall in love with music in the first place? Like, you've been singing since three, but
yeah.
did you hear, again, I'm going to sound very cliche, was it Feirouz in the background when you grew up? Was it what?
It was French music.
French music, like yeah. what? Give me names.
Oh, Lord, you know Charles Aznavour?
Yeah, of course. What?
This guy.
Yeah, legendary.
Jacques Brel.
Okay.
All of those old singers.
Nice.
Because my parents used to listen to that.
Bless them. Good taste, man.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. now Okay, now it makes... Yeah.
Does it? Because
yeah.
I can't connect the French music to what I'm doing
I definitely
now.
Connect. I see it.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, maybe it's an age thing. You know, but no.
Oh, it's
No, it's dope. It's very, very cool. I love it. So was that like? Are you thinking of dropping some French music? Like,
for sure.
Wait.
Yeah, I like.
France, here we come, sending you Michelle.
Yeah, I wish. I'm trying. The thing is, I don't know the slang because my French is the Lebanese French.
Okay.
So it's not really the French slang.
It's funny
so
you admitted that there's a Lebanese French.
Oh no, there is. You know, I feel like I don't know how to speak French when I'm in France. I'm like.
Talk to me in French. I understand French.
Do you? Do you speak French?
No.
You just understand.
Yeah, weird way.
Oh,
but okay. I mean, she's going to hit me up with something scientific right now.
No. I'm going to tell you what I was going to say in
okay.
French.
Okay. Ooh, yellow.
What was I going to say? Oh, yeah. J'ai des chansons. Il y a une chanson que j'ai écrite qui s'appelle All For Me. Et...
you know, again. Je compte. I blacked out. Like I was ready for
so
it. She came up with a different one. What does je pense mean?
I'm thinking.
Ah, yeah. That's what you said? No.
What did I say? I have the memory of a fish. You don't understand.
Yeah, a lot.
Ask me stuff. I don't know what I ate yesterday.
Yeah, French. Okay. Yeah. So, wow, dropping music in French. Okay, that's dope.
Let's see. Let's see.
You like hip hop?
I do.
Rap.
I used to listen to it a lot. I think when I was like 13, 14, Eminem was my all-time favorite.
Nice.
I used to dress like a guy. I used to go and the guys look like...
Wow.
Yeah,
like again, not to generalize. I know a lot of, you know, men and women who are a little bit, let's say, keeping to themselves. They really find comfort in Eminem. I don't know what it is. Like, it's... You're like... Maybe it's his lyrics. Maybe because he's out there. Maybe he's really talking what you really want to say, but you can't say it.
Maybe.
You know,
I think to me it's more the vibe that he portrays because it makes you feel, you know, it pumps you up.
Yeah.
It makes you feel confident, I guess.
Yeah.
When I listen to music, I never pay attention to the lyrics. And that's also probably why I'm not good at songwriting.
Interesting.
I listen to the melody more. And
the melody attracts
vocal,
you more.
Yeah, the vocal capacity or skills.
Producers, how's it been working with, like, you know, obviously AY and I believe Beiruni worked with that. Shout out to him and Nomad.
Yeah,
this was amazing,
God.
By
oh
the way.
God.
Like, I had the pleasure of speaking to that.
I cannot wait for the song to come out.
Man.
The EP.
The EP.
Yeah.
How's it been working, like, with like a guy like AY?
Honestly, to me, amazing because he understands my sound. In the beginning, we were talking.
Yeah.
He listened to the type of music I listen to, which is very, not very different, but a bit different to what he was used to producing. And I think like now he gets my sound and it's very easy, like it's a very easy and smooth process with him when I'm at the studio. Sometimes I agree that, like, he will do something and I'm like, what is he doing? And then he plays it again. I'm like, okay. I see the genius. So I just let him, I'm just like sitting there behind him and he's doing his thing. And he's like, are you bored yet? I'm like, no, I'm just watching. This is interesting.
Wow. So, that's amazing. Okay. Yeah. And tell us about the Nomad experience. How was that like? You know, big up to them and Beiruni for putting all this together.
Yeah,
I think it was really cool to watch, to see like a group of artists all together. And it wasn't only for 1-2 weeks. How long was it?
It was 2 weeks.
It was 2 weeks. Yeah, but was it like
every day?
Yeah, every day.
Almost
see?
Every day.
So like 14, 13 days.
Exactly.
It took commitment. It took a lot of time.
So much fun.
Yeah.
I felt like I was back in uni.
Boot camp. Yeah.
Exactly. And that I was doing, that I was studying music, and I was like, why did I not do this before? Why did I go to nutrition and all of that shit? But no, it was amazing because everybody is so nice. I got to meet a lot of people. So we were grouped in groups of a producer, an artist, and a musician.
Who was your group?
So MGZ, me, and Omar.
Shout out to MGZ.
Yeah.
We see you.
Shout out to MGZ. And Omar Alayan, who's who's a singer. And, shout out to Omar. And I'm like shouting out a lot of people today.
That's good.
I love doing that, yeah.
And it was you. So three people in the group?
Yeah, in our group. So other groups, it was a bit, maybe more or less sometimes too. And what's amazing about the EP is that it's different styles of music. So you have a trance track, you have a... I don't know if I'm allowed to say this.
Yeah, it's all good.
Yeah?
She slipped.
Okay.
When is the EP coming out?
I'm not telling you.
Okay. She backed down.
I don't know.
Is that happening? Michele?
Soon, very soon.
Okay,
keep an eye out. Keep an eye out.
So let's jump into Khalas. Nomad was a cool experience. It was nice. Khalas, okay, wish you had. When it comes to female artists in this region, okay, when I say region, any Arab region, I don't see, sarahatan, there are some incredible stuff. And I love the fact that you guys are all like, you know, sticking to it.
Yeah.
I see, for example, Nadine from Sudan.
Shout out to Nadine.
She is an incredible supporter, man.
Oh my God. You know when you drop the Sudan cipher?
Yeah.
By the way, I swear to God, I'm not joking. I was listening to it every single day in the morning because he used to pump me up. And I don't remember if I knew that she was on it or not.
Mm.
But so I was listening to the whole thing, and then AKA Keys comes in, and I'm like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Like, wow. Wow. Yeah. And then he comes after, right?
She comes after.
She comes after.
Yeah,
and I'm
she.
Like, yes.
Yeah.
Like I started. Yeah, I'm not gonna scream now, but I started yelling like, "Yes,
nice.
Girl!" You know, like, oh my God, she's amazing.
She's amazing. So again, there is definitely some sort of I would say a movement of support between, especially female artists, and it's nice. But again, I don't know. Like, how do you see it in terms of? I want more females to go out there and start representing themselves. I think it's time for men to not to stop representing.
Yeah.
I want women to talk about women issues, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I think Shaybani is very vocal about that, very vocal, and shout out to her. We've had a lot of amazing discussions back and forth about, this lineup is all full of men, why she goes and,
She's
And I think it's important, don't get me wrong. But I think sometimes people don't understand that there might not be quantity, you know? We want
I agree. There's the ratio between men and women here in the music scene is there's a big gap.
Yeah.
From where I see it.
Yeah.
But I feel like there's also a lot of female artists who are not out there too much because and I don't know, maybe I'm wrong, but I see it as maybe us girls, because of society and we're judged, you know, we're like, oh no, but I don't look good to be, I don't know, a singer.
Yeah, but Sadi Khalas, I think that needs to be shattered. Like, I know there's a couple of Saudi female singers, you know, Saudi is one of the most conservative countries in the world, but they're trying to come up right now. There's Ru'ya, there's Lou, there's, I think, also a couple more.
The one who performed with Mulham at D3 last weekend.
Amy Rocco.
Yeah. Like, what?
She's crazy. She's an amazing personality online, and this was the first time she actually gets on the stage and rock
insane.
It. And she was like, you know,
I went like.
Yeah. Yeah. Like, did you know about Amy Rocco before?
No. I didn't.
She's like a big. I don't like to use that word, like an influencer online, but she's huge online, and she's so funny. She started, I think, on Vine. The app, really funny things, and then obviously she really blew up, and now she really wants to experience performing.
She should.
She loves
really
hip hop and rap, and
Like, we have to break this barrier.
Yeah, khalas.
It's the 21st you know, century.
Yeah, but what you said about people judging, I think that is also...
it still happens, for sure.
I think it's a lot of...
The thing is, people are just so opinionated nowadays, and at the same time, they're very sensitive.
Yeah.
So it's like, anything that you do, you have to think, oh, what are these people going to say? Even if you don't care, there's still this thing, like, we're human after all, right? Like,
correct.
I used to think... I used to be this person before who used to think a lot about what other people would think about anything I would do. And now I don't care anymore, but I still have this at the back of my mind.
Yeah.
And what were we talking about?
Females.
Yeah, females.
Mm. I think it's... what you said, I think, makes total sense. But I think, you know, I personally want to see more in the scene. I don't know if it's a cultural issue, tradition issues. I just want to see more. There are a lot, and there is a lot of amazing initiative, like, you know, female first sessions, only, you know, female.
Yeah.
Obviously, even last scene is led by two incredible, you know, women.
Yeah,
and, you know.
Shout out to both of them, honestly.
Yeah, of course. And I think it's, you know.
At the same time, I just thought of this. I feel like you need to be ready to be out there.
Mm-hmm.
So me, for example... When I started last year, I started thinking, why did I not start before? Because it's so easy. And then I'm like, no, I wasn't ready. Last year, there's this click that happened between before D3 Unplugged and after D3 Unplugged.
Yeah.
When it was just the switch of, I'm doing this. I'm done. And there's like, I'm not even thinking about it. I'm doing this. And this is when I was ready. So maybe there are a lot of female artists who are still under the shower sitting.
Yeah. Yeah.
And now they're not
go.
Ready yet.
But I'm telling you, if you're watching this, go.
Yeah. Honestly.
And I remember one time we were at Huna, and Shebani and I were having a talk, also organized by Harmony, which we're going to talk about, you know, soon. And a lady came afterwards and started asking Sara about, like, what do I need to do to take that step? And it's always And sometimes the only answer, I know it's simple, is just go.
Just do it.
Like,
yeah,
fuck it. Like,
it.
What?
Yeah.
What's the worst that can happen?
Yeah,
you know, I just really, I have so much respect for you guys, and it's not easy, really, especially in this region, because we don't have some sort of a system, right?
Mm.
Like, now you drop three songs.
Mm-hmm.
What is the sort of media that you run? What do you do? There's no radios that you can push, like a media run, I'm talking about.
Yeah,
you know, there's a couple of radios that plays the song. Okay, great, you know, yeah. But
also
there's no... bless you, you know, like, but this is like, it's only like a few, not like a run that you go.
I agree.
Publications.
I agree.
You have to know somebody. Mafi ecosystem, يعني معين. You know, I think it's a huge issue.
Mm.
There is support, don't get me wrong, but there's no, like, you know, there's no. In Arab, like, for example, let me give you an example. Hamza Houssaoui, who's an amazing, incredible artist.
Yeah. His voice.
He just dropped a song right now with the Dakar thing.
Yeah.
He went on something called the Media Run.
Yeah.
Because it's in Arabic.
Yeah.
He went on an Arabic radio. Mm-hmm. He went on NBC on two shows. He went on The Insider.
Yeah.
Four or five shows talked about the song.
Mm.
But that's not going to happen if it's English or if it's someone who is Arabic singing English. That's the problem that we have. Which brings me to my next question. Do you think that you can make it here if you're Arabic and performing in English?
Honestly, I don't know. Because Yeah, that's a very good question.
I think if I was the artist, I would say I don't care.
Mm.
And yeah.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Yeah, you know.
See, the thing is, last year, like, ask me last year, do you want to do this as a full-time thing, you know, being an artist? And I would have been like, no, I love my job. I want to do this as a hobby because I don't want to stress about making it out there because it's stressful. There's a lot of competition. There's a lot to do also. There are so many talented people in the world, not just in the region, in the world.
Yeah.
So just to break through and get where you're trying to get is will take time and, you know, consistency and, you know, releasing every single month. But then ask me now, and I want to do this, and I'm trying really hard to get all the aspects right. So now, for example, I'm doing kind of a rebranding to get my brand right and correct, so that you can literally describe it in a few words.
It was Michele.mp3 that went off. Did that annoy you?
So much.
We can feel it.
So much. Because the thing is, I write Michele with one L-E. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
But people either go and write it Michael or
Michael.
Michele. Yeah, I've had that so many times.
Michael?
Every time I walk in, I used to walk in an Uber before I started driving.
Oh.
Like, hi, sir. Hi, Michael. I'm like, Michele. He's like, oh, I'm so sorry. I'm like, Michele. You know, here.
Michael?
Here. I'm not going to go into the other parts of the woman genitalia.
That's what? So, Michael, yeah, how is it Michael?
I don't know. I don't know. It's crazy.
Well, okay, I hear you.
Yeah.
So listen to Michelle is...
Because like if someone goes at listen to, there's a higher chance for them to find the Mish, you know?
Okay.
You know? And I now like everywhere, that. I'm listening to Michelle.
Khalas, everywhere?
Instagram, Twitter, okay. Facebook, everywhere. Khalas.
Nice.
My email, my website, everything. I'm a perfectionist, I can't. Everything has to be the same.
Oh, man.
I stress so much.
Oh. Do you have any instrumentals on your phone?
I do, yes.
Can you bless us with something?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, nice, okay. So I'm going to go and remove my phone as we're doing this. Man, oh man, get ready for some live performances in the car. Whatever you feel like it. Like, what do you feel like?
That's too selfish.
That's too selfish. Okay.
Should I turn on the...
Yeah, 1 second.
Bluetooth?
I need to remove a lot of people here. Okay. You'll be able to find it. We're doing this Buckle Up with Michelle. Definitely check her out. She's an amazing, incredible person. Seriously, you are amazing inside out, and I think this is what I like about you. Like, you get to know an artist, there's a lot of amazing talent, but then when you get them to know them personally, you go like,
all right, I agree,
I'm gonna get all your contacts, let's
exactly
go.
Exactly that, yeah.
Yeah, you know, you go like, it's a huge issue. So
I agree.
I got all her contacts right now.
No, probably, I just pressed on allow.
Oh.
I mean, I don't mind. I don't care. No, but I have...
Michelle M is now connected.
Yes.
Okay.
Michelle.mp3. Imagine.
Yeah, we can tell when you talked about it on social media, you really didn't want that.
Yeah. I tried to make it a funny thing.
I know, it was so funny. Yeah. Marketing is on point. Like, selfish was really cool.
Thank you.
The way you...
I tried.
Like, salute. Okay, what are you going to listen?
Okay.
Is it Spire or Selfish?
Wait.
Or something new.
Do you want something new? I
mean, knowing Azarel, he takes his time for the editing.
Oh, okay.
But I just want to hear. No, feel free. Let's go with what do you feel like performing now?
I feel like performing now. See, by the way, every time someone asks me this, I black out. I'm like, I don't know any song, any lyrics. I just like, I go like.
Fire.
Fire?
Okay. Fire. It's fire.
Sorry, I'm taking my time here.
Take your time, fam.
I can't find it.
You know, this is, you know, it's uncut, unedited, done like this.
I love that.
Yeah. Buzz. Go get water and come back.
We'll have a short break.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen. Where are they?
You're going to be episode 44 or 45.
Oh, nice.
So honored. Thank you for your time again.
Thank you for having me, honestly. I told you, I was so excited.
Bless you.
So I put it as my goal for 2020.
Oh, wow.
But I actually put it for 2021 because I was like, I don't know if I'm like, you know, there yet for you to
for
ask
me,
to be on
look,
it.
Look, a lot of people always tell me that because sometimes you're like, why'd you get this person? They're still, well, for me, if I feel I really want to get to know that person, I'll get them. Buckle Up is not sponsored by anyone or anything. It's just me having a convo with some people. That's it.
That makes sense.
So...
Well, thank you for having me.
Yeah, getting to know you is something I really want. And now, I feel I got to know you. She likes to watch Brazilian series.
Yeah.
She's going to drop something with French.
She's
going to sing Fire
to
now.
Peanut butter.
Oh,
I have to,
peanut butter.
Oh,
nice.
Oh, my God.
Really?
Everybody who knows me
peanut
knows
butter.
That peanut butter.
Okay.
I wanted to do my whole name around peanut butter.
Peanut butter.
I went out to people who have the Instagram handle. Peanut butter sandwich, peanut butter, peanut. I swear,
really?
I was asking them, get mayor. Like, no one was
that.
Answering.
Oh, man.
So I went to listen to Michelle.
Wow.
All right, okay, I found it.
Okay. Just play it to give you a
yeah.
a level. Oh, I think from your phone.
Yeah.
Oh. Take it
Sorry,
away.
It's very low, but
better.
I don't know if they're going to hear me.
Try.
You put your arms around me.
Go.
Forget the world. You lay your eyes on me. And it begins to blur. And we dance alone together. I don't know your name. Our bodies are against each other. Begin to sway. Ooh. put your arms around me, I forget the world. When you lay your eyes on me, the room begins to blur. Then we dance alone together, I don't know your name. Bodies are against each other, we begin to sway.
Sorry, you guys.
Remix.
Yeah, I know. I was like, man, no, but this is really dope. This is really dope, fam. You know, Michele, okay, a lot of people want to hear it all out when you go all out. Like, I feel, I get that sometimes from artists and people, fans, yani. They say, you know, ma, yani, she's not letting go. You're not?
Mm.
Ah, okay.
I know why. So there's, okay. There are two, not excuses, but there are two reasons why.
No, but is that a bad thing, good thing? Like, I don't think it's a bad thing. There's a lot of people that, like, it's not about.
No, I don't think it's a bad thing. I think it's not the best I can give.
Okay.
And I know this. First one being, I have very weak vocal cords because I don't have the breathing correct. So basically, I don't breathe at all. So I have my latest vocal coach. She's actually a speech therapist.
Okay.
Because I went to her and I'm like, every time I go to a bar, to a restaurant, or even now when I'm talking, after talking too much, my throat starts to hurt.
Hurting.
Mm. Wow. And she's like, okay, let's try and fix it. So I go to her one day and we're working on the breathing because everything is connected. Breathing to me being stiff because I used to like sit a lot like this. Mm. So it just kind of like constrains my vocal cords.
Wow, that's crazy.
That one day she goes like, okay, let's try this. And so she puts her hand here in her, on my back for me to like open up my chest and to breathe in. And she's like, okay, breathe in. So she's pushing in and she's like, push my hands out by breathing in. I'm like, okay, so I do it. She's like, what is this? Like, breathe in. I'm like, okay, sorry. So I breathe in and I like open up my chest and everything and it's hurting. It's as if I breathe for the first time. And she's like, how are you even alive? Wow. Like, you have not been breathing this whole time. You breathe just enough for you to stay alive. So I don't breathe enough.
That's crazy.
To be able to project my voice.
Wow.
That's also why when I speak in a very low voice.
Bless you. Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks for sharing that.
No, of course. It's technical stuff. I feel like that's kind of the second reason also. I have the technical knowledge because I've been doing vocal classes. I used to be, when I used to perform in front of my friends, they used to tell me, you look so bored. I'm like, yeah, because I'm not showing you my emotions because I'm concentrating on my voice.
Wow.
Because I used to always be afraid of, you know, cracking or doing her, like hitting a wrong note because of the judgment from others. Because I was scared of what
You know, when you're talking like that, my mind went to think about the people who bash others just because you don't know what they're going through.
Yeah.
And I think it's
hard. Everybody's going through something.
Yeah, you're going through something. You don't know.
Yeah.
The fact that you opened up about this and you're telling us about this, that's okay, a very question on the spot for Michele. Who are the artists you would like listening to here?
So many, honestly, everybody's so talented.
I wanna see if I don't know there's a name that I don't know.
Obviously, Shabani.
Shabani.
Obviously.
Boom, Bani.
Buddy. So Shabani, Moflo.
Moflo.
Latest song, No Promises. I told him. I wanna cover it.
Oh wow.
So
oh wow. I love it when an artist do that. Yeah.
Same.
Yeah.
I recently learned about Seki Supervillain.
Ooh.
Because I saw him perform at I think it was a Ibis event that they were throwing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
First time I see him perform live and I'm like, the energy on him, I was like, wow.
Yeah.
So I really like him, Menon.
We love you, man.
Yeah.
M-E-N-U-N.
Who else? There are so many. Say Framahi that I've collaborated with.
Mm.
Adam Nabil.
Ooh.
So
Adam Nabil.
We have a song coming out.
What?
Me and him. But that's all I'm gonna say.
Wow.
That's
amazing.
I'm so happy about this.
Yeah,
song.
I love Adam.
Mm, yeah,
okay.
So
is it done?
Almost.
Okay.
I have the final mix that you will not. I'll give you an exclusive off the record, so this will be.
Yeah, this is dope. Okay.
Who else? I feel like I'm forgetting people, but not on purpose, because, you know, people are so sensitive. Yeah. I swear I didn't forget you on purpose.
No, I just want to...
Casey,
wow, his latest D3 Unplugged, yeah. Even before...
First time I see him perform.
Yeah, he's crazy on stage. It's very funny, apparently, you know, yeah. And
it's a whole, like, he surprises
whole experience.
You on...
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we have a cool scene, I would say, no?
Yeah,
like
we
it's
do.
A really it's a, it's a, it's a cool scene. What's yeah. missing in your opinion? I don't like to ask that question to is any you have dropped 3 songs. We're not going to be able to discuss right now and buckle up what's missing. Yeah. But in your opinion, as somebody who, you know, you're from Lebanon, how long you been in the UAE now?
Almost 3 years.
3 years. Yeah. And obviously you khalas, you got into the music, mm-hmm. you know, kind of, you know, vibe over here, a lot of, you know. What do you think that needs to be done? And what's the difference between, for example, music here and Lebanon, scene-wise?
So that might be very bad, but I know nothing about the music scene in Lebanon.
Okay.
I know a few performers that I met very, like, at the very end when I...
Who? Like, came, who do you know?
Peter Shoshani.
Yeah?
And, what's his name?
There's Peter, yeah.
There's a guy. Oh, I always forget his name. Nur Nemri.
Oh, I don't know.
So if you haven't heard of him, okay. His voice is insane.
Okay, Noor.
Like,
okay.
He has this raspiness. I'm like, yes, please.
Yes.
Oh, wait, sorry. I forgot to mention someone. Tak.
Oh, Tak, of course.
Enough said. Tak.
Yeah, you know.
Just Tak.
To mention somebody. Tak. Yeah, shout out to Tak. Young beast, man.
Yeah,
it's funny. Looking forward to, you know.
Bounce.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a
February
crazy song.
14, people.
Yeah.
I feel like this is missing, like the fact that people are not excited for other artists. This is what I see.
Mm. Good point.
I don't know if it's fear of, you know, their own following, just leaving them and going to this other person they're trying. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's. I think it's competition because at the end of the day, we're human. Obviously,
yeah.
It is like this is at the back of our mind. But I honestly feel like if someone makes it in the scene,
we all will.
Then we're going to be on the radar
yeah.
as Dubai
yeah.
having a music scene, and everybody will succeed.
Yeah, yeah, big time.
So yeah.
I personally think it. I don't think it's. I don't think it's more. I personally don't think it has nothing to do with jealousy. I just think that sometimes. Maybe I'm talking from a perspective of a blogger or radio.
Yeah.
I get a lot of music, and sometimes if I don't like the song, I don't maybe reply or I don't check it out.
Yeah.
So it's just depending on what. I think we are also, we fall into, if he or she is my friend, I need to push it.
True.
And Saraha, sometimes that can backfire.
I agree.
Now, maybe every song is something that,
I agree.
If you don't share it, oh, hey, how come you didn't share it?
Yeah.
You know?
This I don't, yeah.
You know, like.
I completely agree.
And it's
I don't like that.
Yeah, and it puts people on sheer pressure. And I do get it, you know, like, and that's what friends are for. Like, you need to push it.
But at the same time, friends are there to tell you the truth. If you're not good, you're not good. You know?
I think that's what's missing.
Because
and I'm talking even about myself.
Sensitive.
Yeah. Sensitive, you know. And I tried that 2 weeks ago with a rapper.
Yeah.
He unfollowed me and blocked me and stuff. And all I just said, I didn't feel it, man. That's all. But, you know,
which
I just wanted to
like
try it.
One person's opinion. And I'm not saying that.
No.
You know, like,
I just talked about that. One person will never validate you. Like, even my opinion, Tozen, you know, like, seriously, I'm not the godfather of music or someone who opens doors or whatever. I think in this day of age, though, you are going to open your door.
I agree.
Like, you know, back in the day, Michelle, when they used to break songs, was the DJs that break a song in a club, like that was 15, 20 years ago, and people would hear the song and the song would make it. If it's good, it would make it.
Yeah.
Now, you have the internet. Like, you know, like you can send
it. It's so easy to put out. Mm.
So I think people are, like you said, super sensitive about this, and I think that sensitivity in art, there shouldn't be sensitivity. It depends what the other person is telling you, you know?
I agree. Like, take criticism. So
I think so.
For Selfish, for example, I sent it through to a bunch of, you know, I tried to send it through for review and to get, I don't know, shares or whatever. I got people declining it. I got people approving it to post on their Spotify, for example, or SoundCloud.
Okay.
And the people who declined it, so basically it's a website called Submit Hub.
Yeah.
Go check it out if you
love
haven't.
It.
I don't
know. Yeah.
So good. So I sent out Selfish, and I got a lot of people declining it, and I'm like, okay, I want the feedback.
Yeah.
So I requested for the feedback.
Yeah.
And the first feedback I got was something like, okay, great vocals, but I'm not feeling it. It's too slow, too boring,
or
there's no chorus. And I'm like, I agree. I agree.
Yeah, but also, but that's kind of really weird. Like, I worked in Angami for a year, mm-hmm. and the people there always say that. They said the song should start vocals after 3 seconds. It should be upbeat.
I don't like this at all.
I'm like, you can't intermediate.
All music is going to sound the same.
Yeah,
this is you know, how like, it's
going to
be.
So. Homa, they're just saying what is the music out there that's making it, and this is why the difference between Arab kind of pop artists and us, what we call us, like the alternative kind of scene that is doing music. And I think, like you said it beautifully. Competition, like in Canada, in the UK, in the US, there's so many artists. But I just think that the artists that you mentioned over here, I don't any even you included. You know, I think. The sky is the limit, and I think if you keep doing what you're doing, regardless of what, stop thinking about the milestone, which is reaching. Just be you, and you'll reach.
Enjoy the process.
Enjoy the process. And this is something also I've had to educate myself about, like in terms of do music, halas, for you.
Yeah,
people connected with it, great. Because I really happen to believe that into when your music, you're gonna inspire somebody, you're gonna make somebody remember a certain relationship, a certain aspect of the relationship. Yeah. That is what an artist does, you know. You know, so Erica Badu, I think, said it beautifully. She said, "We're artists and we're sensitive about our shit."
Yeah.
So like,
we definitely.
It's also, you know.
But it's about being kind of open-minded in terms of knowing that not everybody's gonna like your music, and knowing that like there's so much more that you can do and you can learn.
Yeah.
So don't start with this mentality of, "Oh, I'm the shit.
Yeah.
Why are people not listening to my
oh,
music?"
Oh yeah.
It's very easy to fall into that. I've fallen into this before.
Yeah.
And now I'm trying to be like, okay, I'm just enjoying me doing this because I'm having fun, you know, day by day, running around, no sleep.
Yeah.
And I want to sleep. All I want to do is sleep.
So today is 7th of Feb. Yes. You have an event like in an hour and a half when we're driving.
Yes. Oh,
I hope you're having a good time though.
Oh my God, so much. I love this, honestly. No, it's
But what's the event today? Are you performing? Like, what, you know?
So basically.
I know this is going to come out after, but tell us what.
No,
it's something you put together.
Yeah, with my friend who's directing this place. It's called Motorino.
Yeah.
Amazing pizza. I'm only going for the pizza, to be honest.
Okay. Motorino is cool.
Motorino.
Okay.
And JBR. And he wanted me to perform any day. And he was like, just, you know, go, I'm giving you the venue, perform. Like, okay.
Nice. Big up
to
him.
So we said, so we set the 7th of February. And then one day I was like, wait a second. I'm dropping Selfish on the 2nd. And then the 7th is right after, and it's a week before Valentine. Selfish is about, you know, love and stuff. And I'm like, I text him and I'm like, can I do the Selfish event and do it around me? Like, I bring everything. So I told him everything that I wanted to do so that he doesn't have a heart attack. So he's like, yeah, do whatever you want. And I'm like, okay, cool. So I'm like, I'm going to bring peaches. I did stickers. I have like 2 crates of peaches in the back of my car.
Okay, nice, nice.
And then I was like, I'm going to perform there. And I'm going to perform. At first, we said 4 sets. I'm like, 4 sets is too much. Let's do it 2 sets.
Mm.
He's like, okay. And I'm like, I want something a bit more. So I call, I talk to Shabani, Sara, and I'm like, can you please, you know, perform?
Keep performing too. How is it? Oh, wow. Yeah. Okay.
She's performing. I'm so happy because I've always wanted to perform with her.
Nice.
And I was like, the only person I
was that the
think,
first time you guys performed now?
Yeah.
No. Oh, wow.
But we're not performing together today.
Yeah.
So she's performing before me and then I'm performing Selfish.
That's amazing. I'm babysitting my son. Maybe I'll pass by.
Yeah. Bring him with you.
Yeah.
The pizza's amazing. This is where I'm going. I'm not going to sing.
Okay, that's amazing. So, that's amazing. Cool.
Yeah. She's amazing, honestly, for doing this. I love her.
Shout out to both of you. I know that you have very good, it's a good relation, even on online. It's nice to see the support is always amazing there. And big up to read it to everybody as we're driving, you know, in this incredible city, right? Look at this view.
Yeah.
You can't see it, but we're on Sheikh Zayed Road. What is it that you want out of this music thing? Obviously, you started work.
Mm-hmm.
You felt, I want to do something more. You got into music between some open mics and that D3 Unplugged last year. You dropped 3 songs right now, 1 feature. You have a couple of songs in the waiting. You're releasing an EP. It seems that you know what you're doing, you know? You're there.
Not sure.
What is it that you, and it's cool to be unsure.
Yeah.
What is it that you want out of this, like in the next 2-3 years? What is it that you want to accomplish? Is it just, because I asked that question and I'm selfish. I want to hear more of you. I want to hear more experimentation. I want you to, if you want to fuck up, fuck up. I want you to, you know, blow up. I what is it, how do you see yourself, you know, in the next like 2 or 3 years? What is it that you want out of this music thing?
I would like to do it full time. Although, if you're watching this, my boss, she knows already. I love my job. I really do.
Do they understand that you do music?
Yes. Okay. So the amazing thing is that they kind of let me sometimes, you know, if I want to leave a bit earlier for a performance, they let me because they're like, live your life at the same time. It's not all about work, work, work.
Yeah. That's good.
Yeah. So I do love my job, but at the same time, I'm like, do I want to do this or do I want to be a musician? And I think I do want to be an artist full time, but I'll only do it if it makes sense and I can live off it. Exactly.
What's the percentage like between work and...
Oh, you mean now?
Yeah. Is it like a 70% artist or more?
No, it's more work.
Oh, okay.
Wait, you mean in terms of my time?
Wanting
to do it. Oh, 100% artist.
100%?
Yeah. Wow. Okay, fine, 95%.
Wow.
Because I just...
Well, listen,
so
fam,
much.
You never know, like, that break and whatever. The only thing I would say, again, I said it before in other Buckle Ups, the problem is the ecosystem and people, how do they think and feel you? It's a problem.
Yeah.
Because over here, the biggest TV channel, which is NBC, mm-hmm. they don't know nothing about us.
Yeah.
And they don't care.
Which I...
Unless you make it out there, but then teach you. Ali Gatier is coming,
mm-hmm.
you know, and he's, you know, I don't know what you think about him, but a lot of people love
him.
Yeah, you know, and because he's Iraqi, Canadian, made it out in Canada, really connected to the circle of The Weeknd and I don't know what. And now he's going to come. Yeah, and you know, it's always an issue making it out there and then coming back here and them and focus.
So I always had this this thought and I'm like, why? Why is it that?
Yeah.
So I actually want to see what you think about this. Basically, so when I talk to my friends, for example, and I tell them, did you check out this, have you heard of this artist, talking about any of the artists here, like the ones that I've mentioned, Moflo, Men in Tak, Subani. So they're like, no. I'm like, okay, that's one thing, first of all. Like, I repost so much of them, why don't you click on it and check them out?
Yeah.
That's one. Second of all, like, they do check them out, or I sit them down and I make them listen to the song, because I'm like, just listen to it, give it a chance. I feel like there's always this bias of, because they're not international and because they're Arabs, they're not as good.
Yeah,
and
but see, that's also
why?
Yeah, but that's weird. Like, even when you listen to all the artists that you mentioned right now, they're all amazing and incredible, and you know, each one of their style and the vibe. I was playing Moflo on the radio,
mm-hmm.
and my co-host Anna Schofield was saying, like, who's that? Like, you know, like, is that someone from America?
Yeah.
No, like, this is a Syrian artist living in the UAE. So, yeah, I just think sometimes they don't.
We
don't care. That's the zoom
difference.
We don't care as long as if it's not affecting. And this is why it's a problem. Like, had to even with friends. Okay, if you don't sound good, maybe your friends should tell you you don't sound good. You know, like it's
they really should.
You said it. It's sensitivity with artists and stuff like that. It's a huge issue. Social media and Michelle, your friends. Like, how do you like using?
I struggle so much. I
because I want to see a story. Like, you remember. Yeah, Abri, I keep telling him, Abri, man, you're one of the best vocalists, better singer, songwriter, incredible.
His voice.
Yeah,
is just...
but also there's an issue with being on social media.
I think it depends on personality.
Yeah.
Because I'm someone who's not willing to go and share every aspect of my life, which I respect anyone who does that. I don't, like,
true.
It's not for me to judge.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not like this, that I find it hard to post a lot on social media. And at the same time, I'm not someone who likes to take pictures of myself.
Yeah.
Which is also a reason why. So you need to have creative content every time to be consistent. But I don't have time or even maybe sometimes resources to do that.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I'm trying so hard. This is like the biggest stress for me.
Wow. Social media. It's crazy that you said that again.
It's an art.
No. It is an art, but I think we're pushed so much. Like, we're pushed so much, and I have to do social media.
Yeah.
You know? And I think, it's crazy, man. Love talking to you, fam. You're really amazing. And like I said, inside out, and I think you have, I don't like the word potential. I hate that word. I think you be you, and whatever you want to experience in your life, you do it. It's just amazing to see somebody who, you know, a bit, for example, keeping to themselves, using music to let out. I think that is. And the topics that you talk about are really, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're pushing the narrative.
Yeah.
And believe me, a lot of people could relate to that. A lot of people. They might not be able to come and tell you right now on the spot.
Yeah.
But you, what's the sort of best feedback that you ever received, whether on social media or personally?
That my voice sounds like melted chocolate.
Oh, melted chocolate.
Yeah, melted dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate. Yeah. Wow.
Anything that has to do with food, if you say one food item, not broccoli, but you know, like peanut butter or chocolate. Yeah. Like, khalas, like you got me.
Okay. Peanut butter or chocolate, khalas.
Yeah. What else? Yeah.
Wow. Your voice, how does that sound like?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Melted dark chocolate.
Melted dark chocolate.
Is that it?
Yeah, I'll take it.
That's dope. Wow. What scares you, Michele?
Definitely being mediocre. And that's why I decided to do this. Because I don't want to be this person at like, you know, at my what am I saying?
As you grow old, you don't want to be mediocre.
And I'm 80 years old. I don't want to think back and be like, oh, I should have done something about my voice. So now, even if I don't make it, even if I don't end up being a singer, at least I can say I tried. So that's what I don't want.
Yeah, from the feedback that I hear and how people are reacting about you, when you performed recently at the D3 Unplugged, there was a guy that I didn't know, and he was like this. Look at that face. I was like, yeah, that's incredible, man. You know, we do that face. Ah,
the stank face.
It's amazing.
That's the best compliment.
So, in terms of things coming up, we have the Nomad EP. We got Adam Nabil.
Yes. My own EP.
Your own EP.
And that's gonna be.
Is there a name for it or that?
Yeah, it's called Our Story.
Our Story.
Yeah. Because, so basically, actually, Fire, Fair and Fair is part of the EP, right? Mm. And the other two songs, when I wrote those four with AY, I was like, wait a second, there's kind of a succession there.
Yeah.
So the first one, which is Fire, is about meeting someone. Fair and Fair is about, you know, being with the someone, but they're not there.
Yeah.
And then the fourth one, I'm not going to tell you. And the fifth one, the third one and the fourth one, I'm not going to tell you. But basically, it ends at the relationship ending.
Oh.
And I think you've heard that song. It's the one that's a bit dancey.
Ah, I love that song. Yeah.
That's the last one of the EP. And so I was like, why not do a, like, club them together and make it our story, as in anybody's story.
Wow.
With someone.
That's cool.
And, now I'm working on visuals, and I'm working on a whole strategy of releasing, like a marketing strategy.
Wow.
Let's see what happens.
For the past year, do you think that you're getting the support? Do you care about getting that support? When you think about you and yourself, kinda selfishly, when you sit down and go like, how is it doing? You know, are people actually supporting?
Sure. The thing is, I'm not looking for support in terms of like, oh, why did this person not, you know, talk about me, or why did this person not share my stuff?
Yeah.
I don't really care. I honestly do it for me, and at the same time, without caring, they come by themselves.
Yes.
So having, for example, your support and everybody in the music scene that have reached out to me, or that I've reached out and came back to me saying, oh, like, this is really good. I didn't expect it at all. Like, this response, I did not expect. And just that makes me so happy.
Nice.
Honestly, like, and if it comes, it comes. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. I don't want to expect, because if you expect, you get disappointed most of the time. So I'm trying not to.
Singing in Lebanese, is that something we'll ever see you do? Or no?
So, never, but I tried it, and I might have something in Arabic also coming out.
Parents pushing you to do that one?
Not really.
No, okay. No. Okay.
So, because I'm French educated, I talk to my parents in French.
Oh, French,
so,
okay.
Every time I tell them something about me speaking in Arabic, they're like, huh.
Oh, bless them.
Yeah, right. Top.
Tell us something not a lot of people know about Michele. When they say, you know, not a lot of people know. Like, only few people know.
Sure. Okay. So I come off as being very nice and, you know, polite and stuff, but...
You are
this
nice.
This is going to sound so cliche. Yeah. Like, if you cross me, I'll, you know... That's not it. The thing is... So I do my
You
time.
Mess with this girl,
no,
man.
No, on it. Like, the thing is... Yeah, like... Mm. I do Muay Thai, so I
oh my gosh, she started up with that. I thought it was something she does Muay Thai.
Okay. No,
don't mess with this woman, man. I'm just saying.
No, really don't. Because if I kick you with my left kick, I'm gonna break your bones.
Yeah, next time we're doing buckle up on the street. What?
Do you know, funny story, yeah. Actually, when I was done with my master's, and that was when I started doing kickboxing, because my best friend back in the UK, she's still my best friend. I don't know why this sounded as if like back in the UK when I had a best friend, she introduced me to kickboxing, to Muay Thai.
So, okay.
I was training there, and then there was this small break where I started becoming so, you know, obsessed with the gym, that there was a small break when I had to go to France to live with my aunt, just to try and find a job and not come back to Lebanon. And I was like, where am I going to find a gym? And then I used to walk on the street at night with my cousins and be like, I just want someone to come to me so I can, like, you know, just like use my Muay Thai skills and kick them and punch them.
Like, oh man,
that was very funny.
Did you ever put it in use? Just saying. You know?
No, never, never.
Something you can't say
now? I was going to compete at some point.
Wow.
Before coming to Dubai, me and my coach back in Lebanon were talking about it. Yeah, against another girl, obviously. And I'm like, but I can't. Like, she didn't do anything to me. I can't go and beat her up, you know?
Okay.
So, yeah.
Oh, thank you for sharing that. I think that's... wow. Bless you, fam. Wallahi, I really enjoyed this. Every time I say to myself... you know, I want to do buckle ups. I want to make it shorter. But people are liking the fact. I think we've been now 45 minutes plus. And I think, you know, it's also available on podcast kind of form.
I love podcasts.
But bless you, fam.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for being you. And please listen, you have dropped 3 songs, 1 feature. You have a lot of, you know, coming up songs. I just say, you know, embrace the success that you have from just really short, like, you know. We also,
I really do,
3 singles.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I never thought I would be where I am today. For sure. I never thought that I would have a song that people would listen to, that I wrote. I'm like slapping the microphone. That I wrote, and that, like, when I have my friends, for example, come to me and they're like, oh, Fair and Fair has been stuck in my head. And I'm like, how? Like, how is this even
a
thing?
That's amazing.
Yeah.
Anyone you'd like to shout out that we haven't mentioned?
Who have I not mentioned?
Please go ahead. Your friends, family?
My family.
You got 2 sisters.
I have 2 sisters.
Bless them. What's their names?
Tatiana and Karine.
Shout out to Karine and Tatiana.
Yeah, Tatiana is the one who puts up with my shit all the time.
Okay.
So shout out to her big time.
Bless
and
her.
My younger sister, Karine, who's my stylist and my music consultant.
Oh.
And
oh,
I
nice.
Send everything to her and I'm like, should I wear this? Or I'm really bad at all of that. So.
Oh, bless. That's amazing. I wish you all the best.
Thank
I want you
so
to tell
much.
Us your social media handle right here.
At listen to Michelle, not Michelle that I'm just here, guys. Not listen to Michael, listen to Michelle.
Listen to Michelle.
One L E.
Hair.
With hair. The hair. Michelle with the hair.
Bless. Michelle, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so
you guys
much.
Are incredible. You guys, I mean, you are incredible.
Sorry,
your family, I meant the family is important. And this is a message to the family. I'm not sure if they're going to see this, but thank you so much for... you know, showing support. I always say that. I'm very vocal about this, especially with young guys. They can simply say, listen, we don't want you to do music, and they'll cut that off easy. Now, whether you rebel or not rebel, that's something up to you. But I think the fact that they're giving you the chance, the platform, they're okay with it, the blessing, it's truly important. Michelle from Lebanon, and she's here in the UAE, you guys. She's an amazing artist. Listen to her and try to listen to what she's saying, how she's saying it. Before I let you go, real quick, you attended my Today at Apple Talk, and I really thank you for that.
That was so good.
I wanted to ask you about what you did afterwards.
Yeah.
You shocked me. You really shocked me. Because, you know, obviously I have a blog called Revolt, and you hit me up saying, I thought I wanted to do something, was it more impactful? Yeah. I wanted to talk about bigger things or...
Yeah.
Did I inspire you to think like that?
Definitely.
How?
Because in your talk you were talking about, you know, how they're using music to talk about, you know,
politics.
Or everything that's happening, especially in the region.
Yeah.
So I came back home and I'm like, because I always think, for example, money is like the devil. Money is the thing that causes everything, every problem in the world. So I'm like, and then I was thinking, I'm singing about, but it's not fair when you're not there, like. Who cares, honestly? Like, this is such a... I know... I'm, like, bashing myself, but I know that some people do. It's relatable and stuff, but there are bigger things. And we can use it.
But that's amazing. It. You sent me an audio note. I felt so...
It just came up to me. I was like, okay, let's just...
Which proved, again, you have a nice, incredible, amazing voice. And but yeah, be you. And I'm really, 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 really happy that I did this with you guys.
Yeah, me too.
Like and subscribe and all that good shit. Love you guys. Peace and love. Salam.